focuses on cutting-edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class business.
BIMTECH.
One of the great dilemmas of our time is that, one, we don't really know yet for sure what we want to do, and that's something that prevents us from doing things. But two, it's also, we're brought up to feel like, you know, you can't necessarily have a job you enjoy because it's not a good job, you know. And I think it's really important to step back and really think about what is it that you want to do in life. And there's actually a really great Venn diagram that you can create, like I've described in the book. You have to figure out the answer to four questions. What are you good at? What did you get paid to do? What does the world need? And what you love. So it's basically the combination of those four things. And I think we're in a time, the generation, that more and more we also need to think about what the world needs. And that's kind of where the conversation about whether censorship should be there or not be there in the speech is really an interesting one as well, or the debate to be on. But I think everyone is sort of on the right track here, and I think it's really commendable that this campus encourages so much thinking and debate, where I think back in the day it used to be like, no, just learn this, and this is it, you know, it's just this one.
So as you mentioned, you know, that one needs to figure it out, what the world needs, when you figure it out, because when we talk about media, we were only talking about journalism, and not some people talk about just entertainment journalism. When did you realize that India would need only one to do the next level? And, you know, on Instagram, social media, you're at everywhere, and celebrity follows you. So when did you realize the need for being a digital media platform is there?
I mean, I guess because I've been in entertainment for a long time, and I think what happens with media and the press is most entertainment news, unfortunately, is quite negative. You know, we talk about wardrobe shaming, we talk about who's having an affair, who's doing drugs. Unfortunately, it kind of feeds off that what people want to hear. And I felt that what the world needs in terms of media and entertainment is something different. Instead of tearing everything down and tearing people apart, what if we uplift them and celebrate them? And I think that's kind of where I felt that my voice would represent us. Because we have enough people to do that. And I think that everyone individually is trying so hard in this world to sort of get by. You know, everyone here has an identity and a voice and wants to be seen and heard. And that's kind of why we have social media at all, because we want more witnesses to our lives. It's a great line. A movie that says, it's actually in reference to marriage, but actually applies to everything, that says, the reason why people get married or have friends is because they want a witness. They want someone who's going to witness the very good, the very bad, the very ugly, the very mundane. They're going to say that I will be a witness. Your life will not go unnoticed because I will notice you. I will be a witness. And that's really why we created social media, to have that witness for ourselves. And I think that's kind of where I wanted people to find a happier way of doing it and not be so negative and troll each other, which I don't know if you guys watch a show called Black Mirror, it's really something that is kind of really towards the sadness and scary things, right, about where we are technology-wise. One of the things I realized is that you can sit behind a computer and say the meanest thing. I can do that too, and I can do it from a great, you know, place of power, lots of followers, but how hypocritical and what a bully I would be to do that if I can't say it your face, just because I can use technology. So I think that's kind of where I realized that we need to sort of change the lens and prism of
journalism. I have a question on that, which is very much pertinent to our debate, how expression of speech, as you said. We can use the power of social media, we can talk to people, we can sell these. We would come to that, why is this money not doing that? Because that's also part of expression, you know. I'm sure the opponents would have those questions to raise, certainly. But for now, we have, okay, as she was mentioning, you need to know what you're good at, and you need to know what the world needs it. So, who is the first person who needs this money? This book. Alright, the first hand got from here, so she's getting the first signed copy from this money. Ladies and gentlemen, you show up across for this money and for this name. Shall we say, gets the first copy. Yeah.
You must be from Mumbai, I guess.
Are you from Mumbai?
Bihar.
Oh, she's from Bihar.
We were just talking about
we are in Mumbai.
But now we are going to have a panel discussion shortly on the same debate topic. You know, when everyone is speaking here, they all mention about different speakers. When I was in BIMTECH, I was really promoted to have
at the radio station. We were helped trying to help people because they didn't know how to contact each other, and we were told that we cannot talk about anything aside from his sort of public service announcement. And I understand that to some degree it might have been so that, like, the news channels had inadvertently helped the terrorists by showing images of where the police were. But in the case of the radio, we were constantly afraid that we could not mention anything that was at all touching upon news or that might hurt someone's sentiment constantly. So maybe, you know, the students here are not afraid because this is a very comfortable and very, said, you know, a welcoming environment. But as someone who has been here for 20 years and worked in various industries, I was constantly afraid that what if I said something on my radio show that might offend someone political and come and, you know, burn down the radio
station. Oh, so Ms. Malini was stuck to be a jointless entrepreneur who has been working so nicely, and, you know, she said that she was under fear. She could not express her point of view while she was working in the radio channel, and she had witnessed everything. What do you have to say about this?
As far as the controversies of where freedom has been served, etc., I think the people, both sides, have written very excellently. Someone there used the word governance, and I thought that was correct. But governance by whom? By the government, or by the VHS, VHP, or I mean some party, that's one part I would like to ask. But I mean that's just my thought. Now, I have a list here of about 20 controversies that I've written. I'm sure that she's covered most of them. Maya Watanabe, the data, there are many others which I never will talk about. Padmavati has come before. Has come now, but there have been others now very shortly. Only yesterday we had this story about the Malini film, which they made here.
It's scary that it glorifies the concept of Johar. I think the fact that we sort of the
and ask my question to you, which is very personal. What has happened? I mean, when the release was happening, did you watch it? Were you part of screening? Did you see it before?
Yeah, I thought it was my job to see it. You know, but I think for me, I look at film as entertainment and technically, but I also realize the risk of what happens when large groups and masses of people are exposed to something that they will not understand. It's very possible that a large part of the rest of India would be like, wow, we should bring this back, you know, under the guise of, you know, this woman. Compromised if somebody, you know, gets their hands on her. So that's a scary thing. And I'll give you a reason for this, a separate example. I always say, through my entire career, I've been very lucky that I haven't faced any sexism. And I've said this for 4 years, I've been so lucky. Until recently, I was speaking at a conference where a fellow journalist from a big magazine, a big television network, had the opportunity to ask me a question. And I just won, in fact, Most Influential Woman, and I spoke for half an hour about building visual brands. And he asked me this question. He said, I've always wanted to know, Ms. Malini, how have you resisted the urge to have an extramarital affair with one of them? I was just stunned. I was like, one, would you have asked me this question if I was a man? And two, how dare you reduce what I've done into something so insignificant because you thought it was funny? And what bothered me most about it is that everyone in the room laughed. And that is my problem with things like this. Is that if you are someone who's so intelligent and such stature are spreading this, you're going to create that environment. So I do have a lot of issues with how that movie ended. Deeply so.
Did you have any discussion with Mr. Bansali talking about it?
I did not have a discussion with him, but I would have seen him, I would have.
Alright. So also about this movie, you know, this movie has, in the wake of the release of this movie, there's so many questions that we all have. Any from the audience and any questions to be asked from our panelists right now? Yes, go ahead.
Thank you.
larger audience of people.
I don't have a question. I just want to go by the topic that was going on. Like Masrani sir and as well as Malini, they went forward with what they said. I mean, when you are debating, the first thing that we do is we try to reduce it to black and white, and that's something that's really hard. And when we're thinking about a debate like this, we kind of restrict it to books and the industry, and probably movies as well. But then, when you're talking about other spheres, you have to consider the fact that human beings are very impressionable. So freedom of speech and expression, there is some sort of responsibility that the person who's expressing it, he has, he holds.
She said that all of us are like well-sitters, specifically humans are like well-sitters. Whatever falls on us makes an impression. And also, you get a signed copy for asking that question or sharing your views, by the way. What's your name? Smriti gets a signed copy from Ms. Malini. So, that's what an active participant gets. Thank you, gentlemen. Can you have a short for Smriti here? Oh, I agree with what you said, but then there are so